Hello everybody. I would like to present you the DS9 Quick Look plugin. It is an extension that I am implementing to make available a lot of image processing tools that anyone could use without any coding proficiency. This video is both for professional astronomers and amateurs as soon as you use DS9 or are just interested in image visualization and processing softwares. As you may know, DS9 is an astronomical imaging and data visualization application. It's indeed one of the most popular astronomical software for image analysis. Its 30 years of development has made it very stable and easy to use. So because of this, it became an essential tool in all fields of astronomy, but it is still only a visualization tool. And much more profitable, but pretty unsung features, we can add extensions to it. And this extensibility makes it a limitless tool, not just to visualize data, but truly interact with it, process data, and modify it. Then the only limit to this function that you can add is your imagination. Unfortunately, it appears that this extensibility did not inspire or generate a large collaborative and well-organized effort to develop important extensions that would finally, years after years, converge towards a stable and rapid multi-extension package of DS9. Which would make it as essential as Photoshop for photographers. Because I am convinced of its interest, this extension is a very naive attempt to try initiate this tendency. Besides joining the very user-friendly but general DS9 interface with a series of more specific functions, this extension tries to gather a glimpse of all the possibilities that offers DS9's extensibility. Its goal is to allow real-time processing on quick look functions. You can go on the help here if you need more information about the plugin, how to install it, how it works. In order to make it simpler, the quick look plugin is divided in three main extensions so that each of them fills a specific need. So there is the generic extension that tries to fill some gap of DS9 with stable generic function. And gain some time on key functions and try to help the interaction with DS9 of its objects such as header or regions. There is an instrumentation part of the package and an astronomical softwares that links the most essential astronomical image processing software such as Sextractor, Steve, Swarp. Okay, so the only goal of this video is to show you some of the features of this plugin. In order to do so, I'll simply run the function that presents how to use this extension and goes through the most important functions. Do not hesitate to let me know how you feel about it by commenting the video. Okay, so first of all, we'll need an internet connection so that you work on the same images than me, so they are downloaded in the temporary folder and then are just deleted. After each function, we need to hit end to continue. Okay, so first, before going through the most common softwares that have been linked to this extension, let me show you a basic function that will make you earn time. Indeed, even though DS9 is pretty user-friendly, it's not that fast to tune the display to see every features of the on the image. So this function allows you to do everything at once, like this. And if you select a region, it computes the threshold only on the selected region, which can be very helpful. And you can access the function only by hitting Shift plus S. Okay, so now let's hit N for next, and maybe one of the most cited astro software, Sextractor, source extraction software developed by Emmanuel Berta. Very stable too, but in order to change the settings, you have to go through the parameter file and it's not really user-friendly. So with this, you can directly access all these parameters with a GUI and visualize the results of your extraction with the magnitude of your objects. And you can tune them, the parameters, to try improve the extraction. Uh, Okay, we hit N, and now a very important software also. It's for astrometric calibration, and can be of huge interest for amateurs who take pictures of the sky. It will run a lost in space pattern recognition algorithm to try compute the location in the sky of your image. So the function will upload this image of the regions that you have defined on the brightest stars to astrometry.net, and then it will download from astrometry.net the WCS header that it computed, and this will be added to the image that you are seeing on DS9. So here you can see that it took only 2 minutes to run the recognition algorithm. Okay, hit N key, and the next step for astronomers when they have access to the world coordinate system of their image, it's then to stack some images to create bigger ones or increase the signal-to-noise ratio by stacking the images. So here are such images. On a small hint here, there is a quick function that helps. It's a lock or just shift on L, and that will help you access all the locking parameters at once. So here, if you select WCS, you will see that your images are from different part of the skies. Then if you hit N, you can use swap software, also developed by Emmanuel Bertin on Very Stable, to co-add the images. So swap performs background subtraction and noise level measurements for automatic weighting in order to resample and co-add fixed images using any astrometric projection defined in WCS. Again, here are all the parameters that you might want to change, but the goal here is not to explain them. You can put here the path of your files. It will go through an improved regular expression matching with stars, bracket, even with several digit numbers. And if you don't put any, it will simply use the files that are loaded in DS9. So of course, here this training function that launch the function itself, but all of these functions are accessible either in the analysis menu or by searching for it here. And here's the results. Okay, so let's hit N. And when astronomers popularize their work, they can use stiff function to generate more from scientific feeds image, more popular TIFF format images for illustration purposes. It can be run in single image mode, but for more realistic outputs, you can run it with three RGB filter images. You can just put the path here or load the images in DS9 in the good order. So here, you have a nice image of what the sky would look like if you had super cool eyes. Okay, so this is a good overview of the softwares that I've linked to DS9. Now let me show you some of the generic functions I have implemented. Everything is implemented under Python 3. So let's hit N. A first simplistic but interesting feature is to take advantage of the 3D plotting capabilities of Python to see your image in 3D. So here it is. But you could also do a 2D Gaussian filling of your stars to compute the seeing or the sigma of the point spread function of your instrument if you are doing some instrumentation. Hit next, and it is not included, as it is not included natively in DS9, I added the possibility to do some radial profiles and have the uncircled energy that you can see here. I also wanted to add some 1D filling algorithm, so I added some filling code that I have adapted from Geoffrey Leibniz code. Two interests for this function. First, you can choose the features that you want to add to your function. A polynomial background, add another low, and also add several Gaussian features if you want to fit some emission or absorption bands, let's say. The second interest of this code is that you can tune the initial guess of your fit so that it's almost sure that it will converge. When you are satisfied with your initial parameters, you can just click on fit, and this will fit the data that you have. There are also interesting features that you could use if you are doing instrumentation.
One of the most interesting one, I guess, is to perform a through focus analysis. Just have to select your sources when it's close to focus. You can put the path of your images, so it n, but if you let the dash, it will just take the images in DS9 in the good order. So there you have the different estimators of your through focus so that you can choose the best position of your optics or the detector based on the FWHM or the uncircled energy. Also, if you do some observation, you might need some basic guiding algorithm in order to keep track of some stars in real time or just on a fiber source while if you are changing your instrument setup or want to do an analysis through focus in real time if you do instrumentation. So it will guide on the stars and give you in real time flux sigma and distance from initial center while you are while you're getting your images. Okay, so this test function is over, but for sure there are plenty of other interesting functions that are implemented, such as different type of stacking, get depth of an astronomical images, cosmic ray removal, autocorrelation, Fourier transform, work with data cubes, etc. There is one last function that I would like to show you because it can be one of the most powerful when you are struggling with hundreds or thousands of images with different header information, which at some point was my case. It is actually the combination of two functions. First one is the creation of a header database. It takes all the images you give. Here again, you can command option C on the Mac to copy the path of a file and then use regular expression pattern to look on all the images that you want to give. The function will concatenate all the header information included in the images. You can have multiple extension in your FITS image. There is only zero, so it just takes 2 seconds, as you can see, and then you have all the information at once: amplification, gain, exposure time, etc. It can directly be visualized with Excel, for instance, but it's also very easy to analyze with StopCat. But even more important, it can be linked to another function that actually orders all these images with different selection and ordering rules. For instance, if you want to run a test or an analysis on a subset of images, you can go here and create image subset. You enter here the path with command option C on Mac. And then, let's say you only want to have images that have a gain lower than 10 or higher than 1,000, let's say. Also, you can tell how you want to order it. So for instance, here we want to put the EM gain first and then the different exposure time. All of the images are then ordered in your DS9, in your new DS9 backup folder in your home directory. And this will only be symbolic links so that it does not wait anything on your server or computer. It really made me earn precious time on experiments to have this small function. All of this, of course, is to try to improve and make easier our way of interacting with astronomical data, gain time for a quick look and image processing, and also try to propose an initial package so that there is no need to reinvent the wheel each time we want to perform a radial profile or any basic function that is actually not that totally trivial to implement. Also, I want to stress that this interaction between DS9 and some other Python code that you have is very easy to implement thanks to the PyDS9 package, so do not hesitate to do your own codes. I will do another video after releasing this DS9 Quick Look extension. Thanks for watching.